knees underneath the hip points, tops of the feet on the mat. And then we can spread our fingertips out wide. And we're going to do cat-cow again and feel the difference. So we'll take a big breath in, dropping the belly, lifting the tailbone. Exhale to round the back. Look towards the navel this time. We're going to press into the palms. Feel that big shoulder stretch here. Big breath in to drop the belly, lift the tailbone. Feel that lower back stretch here. And on the exhale, round the back for our count. A big breath in, the biggest breath you've taken all day. And on your exhale, option for lion's breath, letting the tongue hang out a big roar. Do a deep breath in, and one more opportunity for a lion's breath. We're just create a little bit more movement here. So you can sway with the hips. You can create circles with the hips. Rock back and forth. Find what feels good for you. As you move the back, you can move with the hips. Spine feels good. Shaking out parts of the body that feel tight or tense. And then we're going to come to a neutral position with a tabletop. So a flat back. Let's bring the knees out as wide as the mat, toes come to touch. Then we're coming to our child's pose. So option to use our bolster for a nice cushion on our torso. So option to have the knees over the hips or knees over the ankles. Our torso comes down either on the mat or the bolster. Arms can be straight reaching or elbows can be bent to open up the chest. A restorative pose, so find what feels comfortable for you. If the hips don't feel good, you can bring the knees closer together and you'll be in more of a puppy pose. Let's focus on our breath. Let's do our equal breathing. So same count, the inhale as the exhale. So you can choose how high you want to count, but make it full and satisfying breaths with no holds. So take a big inhale in until it feels good. So count up. And then when you can't inhale anymore, let it go to the same count as the inhale. If you'd like to make it a little longer the next time, that's great. Just make the exhale a little longer too. So find your count. I like to close my eyes and picture a circle. Make it bigger. As we inhale, like a balloon inflating, then on the exhale, slowly get smaller. You can take big inhales through your nose and out through your mouth, making an O with your mouth like you're blowing out a candle. As you exhale, you feel your body melt a little deeper. So switch the direction you're looking in, give the other part of your neck a stretch. Keep counting and breathing.
just want you to take note of the number that you got to, your highest number, just so you know for next time where to start. And to just note your progress. So maybe we can go a little deeper next time. So we'll let our breath go back to normal. We can stop focusing on numbers. Slide our wrists underneath the shoulders.
So you can move the bolster out of the way. We're going to keep the knees out wide. So option to just readjust. Just find what feels good with your hips above your knees. Knees wide, toes touching. And then we're going to bring the left hand on the ribs. Big breath in to reach up towards the ceiling. Open up the chest. Exhale to bring the left hand in between the right hand knee. Right hand reaches up towards the top of your mat. Both arms are straight. And we're just relaxing here. Relaxing with every exhale. And on the exhale, right hand comes underneath the shoulder and we'll bring ourselves back up in the hands and knees. Get ready for the other side. So right hand this time comes on ribs. Big breath in to reach up. Exhale, right hand comes in between the left hand and knee. Left hand reaches up towards your bolster. We'll just try to relax the lower back as we exhale. Another big breath in. And on your exhale, left wrist comes underneath the shoulder. We'll press ourselves back up into hands and knees. And then we'll bring our knees underneath hips.